The Danish authorities have imposed another ban on pocket wagons with semi-trailers from the Great Belt Bridge connecting Denmark with Sweden. The ban resulted from a potentially threatening situation that happened last week on the 13th of January, involving a freight train of DB Cargo Scandinavia. The measure is understandable, especially if we take into consideration the fatal accident that happened on the same bridge a couple of years ago. However, in the long term, it could prove detrimental for the intermodal transport market. After contacting DB Cargo Scandinavia, the company said that claims reporting a near accident are far from reality and might prove disorienting for the public. It also claims that the freight train in dispute underwent all the protocol controls before the trip. It had all the needed approvals, and nothing indicates that there was some kind of omission that led to the incident. In addition, DB Cargo Scandinavia has acquired the CCTV footage from the cameras positioned on the bridge. From the footage, we see that it appears that the train's front part was lifted slightly due to strong winds during the incident, and that led to a train socket to get partly off from one of the pocket wagons. On the other hand, the Danish authorities have a different perspective. According to the Danish Transport Construction and Housing Authority, it has so far been proven that the semi-trailer was outside the profile of the freight train. The semi-trailer had shifted position and it protruded beyond the side of the freight wagon. However, it is critical to note down that similar reports have only been made in Denmark, and specifically on the Great Belt Bridge. For instance, in the rest of Europe, there are no reports concerning safety of semi-trailer freight transport. In particular, semi-trailer freight transport is considered to be quite safe, especially in relation to road transportation. In the last 13 years, there have only been two accidents reported, and specifically in Denmark, Denmark is considered to be one of the most safe countries in terms of rail transport. It has an exemplary safety record, and the last accident before 2019 took place in 1988. Consequently, there is a critical question arising. Are the safety measures enough for transportation on the Great Belt Bridge? Should maybe the authorities take into consideration weather conditions and how critical they can prove in terms of causing accidents? So far, we already know that in the 2019 accident, weather conditions also played a critical role. However, the only measure trying to secure safety in terms of winds is the speed limit for the trains. Maybe there should be a better operational management on this aspect, and maybe if legislation and rules get reconsidered, this should be the main focal point instead of banning semi-trailers from the bridge and causing huge financial problems in the whole market.